All right, let's get an update on the weather now. Tropical storm Dindo has left the Philippine area of responsibility. Let's get the latest from ABS-CBN resident meteorologist Ariel Rojas. Ariel, over to you.
Hi, good afternoon, Carmina. Tropical storm Dindo, with the traditional name Jongdari, which formed Sunday evening over the northern Philippine Sea, left the Philippine area of responsibility at 9 this Monday morning. However, its rain bands may still bring scattered rains over Batanes and the Buyan Islands. No wind signal was raised during Dindo's short stay inside a country. Most of the Philippines is experiencing warm and humid conditions due to the absence of the southwest monsoon or habagat. However, thunderstorms may be possible later this afternoon in Cordillera, Central Luzon, Calabarzon, Mimaropa, Bicol, Western and Eastern Visayas, and Sogsaron. Rain showers may last up to nighttime here in Southern Luzon. Metro Manila may also experience afternoon showers today. Meanwhile, the air quality over Metro Manila and Calabarzon remain poor, and based on the air quality monitoring of the Environmental Management Bureau of the Department of Environmental and Natural Resources at 10 a.m. Monday, stations in Caloocan, Parañaque, and Pateros are unhealthy for sensitive groups, while Makati logged a very unhealthy air quality. Private air quality monitoring organizations also show moderate to unhealthy air quality in Batangas, Northwestern Laguna, Cavite, and Metro Manila. The poor air quality is attributed to the VOG emission from Taal volcano. FIVOL said Taal emitted more than 3,300 tons of sulfur dioxide, which plumes reached more than 2 kilometers into the atmosphere. And around this height, the winds drift northwestward. Health experts advise the public, especially those residing near the volcano, to wear N95 masks. That's the latest on the weather. This is Ariel Rojas. Back to you, Carmina.
Thanks a lot, Ariel Rojas, there joining us live. Actor Sandro Mulac has filed a complaint against two TV writers who allegedly raped him. Our very own Zian Abrosio on the line now with that story. Zian, over to you.
Casey, actor Sandro Mulac formally filed a complaint before the Department of Justice on Monday against two GMA independent contractors. Sandro and his father Nino Mulac arrived at the DOJ at past 8 a.m. Monday to file a complaint of rape through sexual assault and multiple acts of lasciviousness against the two independent contractors, Jojo Nones and Richard Cruz. The respondents in the sexual abuse complaint filed by Sandro Mulac earlier responded with absolute denial of all the allegations, according to their lawyer. According to the NBI, they have 4 witnesses against the two independent contractors, including Sandro's father, Nino Mulac, the girlfriend of Sandro, his male friend, and attorney Annette Gozon, GMA Network's senior vice president for programming, who submitted her statement as public document. After the witnesses arrived, Nino Mulac was teary-eyed in saying that he waited for this moment and they expect to attain justice for what had happened to his son.
Ang bigat kasi nakikita mo yung anak mo araw-araw na nagsisuffer, hindi makakain, hindi makatulog.
And that's the latest here at the Department of Justice. Zian Ambrosio, ABS-CBN News.
Thanks a lot, Zian Ambrosio. They're joining us on the line. Senator Robin Hood Padilla issuing a clarification on his controversial statement on maritime relations and make that marital relations and marital rape. Padilla has drawn flak for raising the sexual rights of Filipino husbands on their wives during a recent Senate inquiry. The senator asserts he does not condone or promote any violence or abuse within the bounds of marriage. Padilla says he merely posed a hypothetical question to elicit a response from resource person, adding the issue of marital consent is an often avoided topic in the country. More Filipinos from Lebanon expected to arrive in the Philippines by the end of the week. The Migrant Workers Department says around 45 more Filipinos are set to be repatriated as the fighting between Lebanon and Israel intensifies. 15 Filipinos were already repatriated from Lebanon over the weekend. The DFA adds no OFWs are in the border of Beirut, where Hezbollah and Israeli defense forces are clashing.
Merong napipintong at least 45, no? Meron 15 umuwi nung weekend, at ngayon merong 45 na napipintong umuwi ngayong linggo na to, most likely. And meron, patuloy pa rin ang repatriation effort. Voluntary repatriation mode po tayo sa ngayon. Level 3 tayo, patuloy ang pagmamanman natin ng sitwasyon, at especially koordinasyon between the DFA and the DMW, napakahalaga po sa panahon na to. Nakahanda tayo. Itong repatriation ay simula pa. Nagsimula ang hidwaan noong Oktubre. Matagal na rin tayo nagbibigay ng libreng repatriation and post-repatriation, post-arrival assistance dito sa Pilipinas.